Hey there, Marshall here from Limited Resources, and we're going to do a little Eldritch Moon draft here on the pre-release. So this is early in the format. I'm in Australia to cover the Grand Prix and the Pro Tour that for Eldritch Moon. So kind of cool. So we've got a Wharf Infiltrator here as our rare, which is a strong rare. It seems to have performed pretty well so far. Abundant Maw is solid. What else we got? Spreading Flames is a good kind of a ramp target. It's 7 mana, so it's expensive, but its effect is profound on the battlefield, and that's pretty nice. Tattered Haunters got in for a lot of damage from what I've seen. These cards are all whatever. I think Spontaneous Mutation is fine. I think we'll go for the Wharf Infiltrator. I have actually had it in one deck so far, but only one, and that's not a big sample. I like to try to, you know, kind of play these cards out a little bit more than that and figure out what's good and what's not. I love a Drag Under here. There's also a Thermo Alchemist, which has really impressed me. Rise from the Grave is certainly fine. Borrowed Grace sometimes just steals games from your opponent. I'm going to take this Drag Under here and just stay on color. I think it goes well with the Wharf Infiltrator as a kind of 1-2 punch, getting a small blocker out of the way and attacking with the Wharf Infiltrator. You can start. Here, I'll zoom it in for you a little bit here. As you can see, you can start making 3/2s while improving potentially your card quality in hand. So it's pretty good. And Drag Under is a card I'm a big fan of in this set. Look, this isn't the big exciting splashy card that you hope to get, but you know, the effect is significant, and it costs your opponent usually more tempo or sometimes the same that it costs you, and you get the card back anyway. So what's not to like there? All right, another Abundant Maw. Ooh, here's a clear shot. I'm going to take that most likely. I will look at the rest, though, of course, just to make sure there's nothing that jumps out. Well, that's interesting. I think there is actually a reasonable choice here between Clear Shot and Thermo Alchemist. Thermo Alchemist is going to fit into the shell that we've developed so far quite a bit better. Clear Shot, though, is a much more powerful card. I think it's one of the better uncommons. It leads to a lot of 2-for-1s, and it's a very common 1-for-1 scenario as well. But Thermo Alchemist is one that's I've been really impressed by, and I think it would go better in this blue shell that we've got the first two cards of. You know what? Let's do it. Let's take the Thermo Alchemist and see if we can't make this deck work. All right, well, I felt a little bit bummed because there's an Ulvenwald Captive, and if we would have taken that plus the Clear Shot, I would have been pretty happy. But I gotta say, picking up a Galvanic Bombardment fourth pick is nice here. This is the perfect card for this type of deck, and so it looks like maybe we are on the right track after all. So I like that. Unfortunately, this pack's not quite as exciting. There's a Laboratory Brute and a Fogwalker. These two red cards are, I think they're basically unplayable. They're not cards I'm looking to pick here at all. So the question is, do we want to get, you know, the small Skulk creature here or the Laboratory Brute? And I'm just going to take the Fogwalker. Card's been okay. Nothing great. All right, this is a nice little payoff. Oh, wow, another Thermo Alchemist. Huh, I skipped right past that. Wretched Griff is really good, but yeah, you know what? We're doing it. Let's just be all in on the Thermo Alchemist. Let's just see how far we can push that. I think it is important in the early part of formats to really explore archetypes fully. And, you know, I do think that, for example, the Clear Shot is a better card. But, you know, that I know what the Clear Shot does. I already know that. And the Thermo Alchemist is a card I've experimented with. I've had it in two different drafts, and I've been impressed by it. But I really want to see, you know, what can this thing do? Same thing there. You know, the Wretched Griff, I think, is a more powerful card in general. But the Thermo Alchemist is part of a bigger plan, and I want to see if I can make that plan work here. All right. Unfortunately, it looks like we're getting bricked here. I'm just going to take this Ironclad Slayer. I just think it's the best card in the pack, so I'll just take it in case we end up switching colors, or, you know, you never know. It's still relatively early in the draft here, so things can change around. Sometimes they do. Okay, interesting. So there's an Identity Thief in the pack, as well as a Take Inventory. And a Take Inventory would definitely make the cut in a deck like this. Yeah, it's not exciting. It just draws you a card for 2 mana, and then occasionally if you get more of them, you can get more value out of it. But with two Thermal Alchemists, that's the kind of card that you want. It's just cheap, it cycles, and it keeps things moving. Though I haven't actually played with Identity Thief yet. God, it's got to attack to be any good at all. Yeah, you know what? I'm just going to take the Take Inventory here then. We need spells, and you know, I would probably pick up as many of these as I could get, just because, well, the more you have, the better they are. Curious Homunculus, Enlightened Maniac, and then there's also a Spontaneous Mutation. So this is a pack that we opened. The Curious Homunculus can help us cast these cards, and it does become a pretty powerful threat in Voracious Reader on the other side. You can see it's a prowess creature that's 3/4, which is already pretty good, and then it reduces the cost of your spells. You know, I'll try it out. I don't really like this card that much. I think Spontaneous Mutation is better. But Spontaneous Mutation doesn't really work super well with this deck just because it's, you know, not an instant or sorcery. Though I do think it's a better card. Like, again, if I was sitting at a GP or something like that, I would probably just take the Spontaneous Mutation there. But I haven't actually got a chance to play with Curious Homunculus, so I think it's worth looking at here. All right, not much really going on here. Maybe we'll play this Fortune's Favor. I have played it, and I found it kind of mediocre. It's not great. Also, the other Thermal Alchemist did not come back, though I wasn't necessarily planning on that. It was, as it was, a few picks into that pack. All right, well, we've got a start here. We know what we're trying to do. We want more Dragunders, more Thermal Alchemists, and just other ways to cheat in incidental damage, and I think we'll be set. All right, what do we got? Well, we got a Weaver of Lightning. That's a really good start. Ingenious Scob, fantastic in a deck like this. And Make Mischief, I think, would make the cut in most scenarios. But yeah, we're slamming Weaver of Lightning here. That's exactly the type of card that we want to see. This thing turns your cheap removal spells into real removal spells, and it turns, you know, even random card draw spells into things that can kill creatures occasionally. All right, well, we got a blue Mythic Rare, but unfortunately it's Mind's Dilation, which is not a good card. It's actually just terrible. But fear not, we got a Savage Alliance, which is an absolutely fantastic card. Just a savage beating is what it should be called. Yeah, this card's fantastic. I'm going to slam it here. And then maybe, if we're really lucky, we get back the Exultant Cultist. The Brute is kind of medium. But this is a great pickup for our deck. Weaver of Lightning and Savage Alliance are really a great way to start the second pack here, so I'm pretty happy about that. Okay, here's another Take Inventory. There's also an Imprisoned in the Moon. Ooh, Rune Rider's pretty good. And Make Mischief. Abandoned Reason's not what we want in a deck like this. So it's between these two, Take Inventory and Imprisoned in the Moon. I'm taking Imprisoned. Yeah, it's not an instant or sorcery, but it basically just deals with any threat, and that's just really hard to replace in these colors. These colors, especially with the Weaver of Lightning, you know, you can find burn spells sometimes that can take care of small threats, but the big threats can be a real issue, you know, 5 toughness and stuff like that. So getting an Imprisoned in the Moon seems good, and then also there's a decent chance that we wheel the Take Inventory. It's not a card that people take highly. You know, you're usually either the person at the table that wants them all, or you just don't want them at all. So there's a good chance we wheel it. Whoa. Oh, here's a good pack. Stromkirk Occultist is pretty good. I'm actually going to take the Smoldering Werewolf over it, though. I think this card is fantastic. I love this card. It has really overperformed for me. And then there's some good ones. Tattered Haunter, Make Mischief, and then these two are... This one's probably not a card we'd like, but the Stromkirk Occultist. So maybe we wheel something. There's going to be 4 cards left. There's a chance. It's probably not likely, though. Still, that's fine. Again, another uncommon. We're kind of slamming the powerful uncommons here. Okay, here's an interesting choice. An Ingenious Scob would be good, but I'm going to take Scour the Laboratory because I just love this card. And this is the kind of powerful late game play that can really help you dominate. Also, we can power it out a little bit early with the Curious Homunculus. Sweet. Another Weaver of Lightning? Wow. God, that's great. I was hoping to get another Thermo Alchemist out of this pack, but getting two Weaver of Lightnings is just better. Well, here's an interesting decision. So we can take Shreds of Sanity, which I think is actually a little better than it looks, and especially in a deck like this, you can often get things back. Maybe you can even get a little Madness going or something like that. But we could just take a Spontaneous Mutation, which, again, is also quite good in a deck like this. It doesn't fit the theme, but it's just a, you know, effectively a removal spell, because in many cases, you are just trying to set up a scenario where you can just sit there and ping with Thermo Alchemist and such. Yeah, I'll actually go for the Spontaneous Mutation this time. We didn't pick the other one, and I do want to make sure we have one, so that's good. All right, the Cultist is here, and then there's also a Grizzled Angler, which lets you mill yourself for two, and then if you've got a colorless creature, it becomes this nasty beast. Interestingly, we do not have any colorless creatures currently, so is the Cultist better? I don't think the Stencia Innkeeper is better than either of these two, so I'm not really looking at that. Same thing with Turnicide. I guess I'll just take the Angler here. I haven't played it yet. Doesn't seem great. All right, there's a Make Mischief coming back. That's going to make the cut for sure, or almost for sure. It's not a big effect, Make Mischief, just one damage to a creature player and you get a little devil. But being a sorcery means that it's going to trigger the things that we want to trigger, and then with the two Weaver of Lightnings, it's often just going to be two damage to something, and then all of a sudden that card's, you know, much better. Prophetic Ravings. All right, that Laboratory Brute is the one that came back. Fine. Hey, the Take Inventory Wield, I'm into it. That's what we were hoping. I'm going to take it over the second Make Mischief. I like keeping our curve a little bit lower. And hey, we got the other Make Mischief back anyway. I don't know if that one's going to end up making the cut or not. We'll see what kind of cards we get in this last pack. So that pack was very good for us. The double Weaver of Lightning being the highlight. The slight bummer is that we didn't pick up a third Thermo Alchemist. We did pass that one in the first pack, but... this deck I think would be a lot better with that, because this can be a win condition for sure. But still, that being said, I like where things ended up. All right, what do we get here? Well, we got a Rise from the Tides. We could just do that. I've got a Laboratory Brute and a Grizzled Angler to put cards in our graveyard, as well as just casting them. That's interesting. That might actually be our win condition or a good win condition. Dissension in the Ranks, a card I'm not a big fan of at all. Gone Missing is mediocre. Uncaged Fury can be good in a deck like this, but we didn't really get the pieces. And then Press for Answers goes great in the deck as well. I do think that Rise from the Tides has a very good chance to come back. I don't think that there's many people that really want that. Press for Answers is a little bit better. I'm going to take it here. I'm not even convinced that we were super into a Rise from the Tides. What the? That doesn't look right. There we go. Reduced to Ashes. Nibbless of Dusk would be good. And then Tormenting Voice is good too. Feel like we probably just need the Reduce because we've got a decent amount of removal spells, but don't have a ton to deal with bigger creatures. So I'm going to take the Reduce here, and then hopefully we'll get back the Nibbless or the Tormenting Voice. Those would both make the cut. Some good cards in here, but not for us. That's a little bit sad. The Neglected Heirloom. That would go on here. Not currently on here. And it would go on here, though. If you turn that guy over, you're probably winning anyway. Yeah, unfortunately, there's really just not much for us here. There's some really powerful cards, the Nearheath Chaplain, the Pack Guardian, the Heirloom's pretty good. I think I'm just going to end up taking the Heirloom here. Uncaged Fury on what? That's the question, right? On a this or something? You know, it just doesn't look that good. So I'm going to take the Heirloom. Though I wouldn't be surprised if this didn't make the cut. We'd need to pick up quite a few, like, werewolves, red werewolves here to make that worth it. Okay, an Uninvited Geist, Adjust the Wind, and another Press. I'm just going to take Uninvited Geist. I think that that's another reason that maybe we could fit this Neglected Heirloom in our list. And also, it's just a nice little clock. That is what you want here. Okay, not much going on for us. The Stone Quarry, is there anything we want to splash? Ironclad Slayer, not really. I'll just take a Dual Shot. I think Dual Shot is almost main deckable now. Sanguinary Mage, huh? I could take a Drownyard Explorers or a Sanguinary Mage. Sanguinary Mage does seem like it fits well in this deck, though, with all these instants and sorceries going around. Insolent Neonate? Sure. Unlikely to make the cut. I don't think I really want to play it. Okay, Tormenting Voice seems good. And the Rise from the Tides did come back. You definitely see playing it. We do have a lot of different ways to mill ourselves. The Wharf Infiltrator, Tormenting Voice gets things into the graveyard. And then we've got the Grizzled Angler, which can do it too. And there was more. Where was it? The Laboratory Brute. So, I don't know. If we end up playing all of those, then that could be something that we're interested in. A Rise from the Tides. Also, we're just casting these, you know, these take inventories and stuff and kind of just churning through our library. Let's see this dumb guy. I think I'm going to kill this Heirloom. I like the idea of the upside of it, of getting it on an uninvited Geist and going to town. Which this deck can set up, but otherwise it seems very mediocre to me. It's interesting. I think the Laboratory Brute is the card I'd want to cut the most, but if we do end up playing the Rise from the Tides, then I do want it in. Yeah, I'm not sure what to cut here. I think we could cut, like, a Press for Answers is probably a reasonable cut. I think the Make Mischief is medium, but yeah, I'm just gonna cut the Press. All right, this deck looks sweet. I don't know how good it is, but it's sweet. Sure. Looks like our needs are pretty well split down the middle. I think I'm going to favor mountains here. This is just, you know, me kind of guessing. So this is 9-8. You know, given our color preferences, I don't think it particularly matters. So the question is, which one do we want one more of? And I decided to go with red because Galvanic Bombardment on turn one or two can be pretty important where Spontaneous Mutation is not. And then looking at these, getting a Thermo Alchemist down first is more important than casting a Take Inventory in most scenarios. And same with Tormenting Voice, since it's a really good way to dig you out of a situation where you don't have enough lands or whatever. So we'll favor mountains. It's a close call, but we'll do that. Okay, blue-red spells. Let's do it.